Apple recently previewed the next generation of CarPlay, so let's create a gauge in Adobe XD. Start off with an ellipse and draw out the shape of your first gauge, holding down Shift to create a perfect circle. To help subtly blend this element with the background, the fill can be shifted to black. Then a background blur can be enabled in the Properties Inspector. Crank up the blur amount, drop the brightness, then increase the effect opacity to slowly bring back the fill. Around the inside, let's work on the meter. Another ellipse can be created or duplicated from the original, and for this shape, we'll want to focus strictly on the border. I'm going to bump up the size to around 44, but if you're designing larger or smaller, you may need to tweak these values. To create the opening, let's adjust our dashes and gaps. We'll bust it wide open by bumping up the gap quite a bit, over 9,000. You don't need to go that high, but it works. Now the dash can be increased to create the arc, and like the size value, this will differ from design to design. The shape can now be rotated to set the start and end points, and if desired, the caps can be rounded off. With one in place, we'll want one more to use for the speed marker. For the shape in the back, since we won't need to adjust the border going forward, we can outline the stroke under the Object, Path menu. Styling-wise, let's add a touch of flare to the larger arc with a linear gradient. Definitely get creative with your colors, but I'm going to keep my gradient on the simpler side, going for a muted green to purple. Maybe adding a touch of blue in the middle. For the speed marker, our goal is to emphasize the filled-in portion. So keeping the color at white, we can set the blend mode to something like overlay to achieve just that. Next up, we need a few text layers, most notably the speed in the center. If you're following in Apple's footsteps, you'll want to use the San Francisco typeface. And for the larger layer, a heavier rounded font will look great. Then for the smaller layers, let's go for the less rounded alternative. With our main gauge complete, the elements we've created can easily be used to tack on additional meters and widgets for our experiences. And that's how to quickly create a CarPlay-style gauge using Adobe XD. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Be sure to subscribe for more content. Follow me on Twitter, and I'll see you all next time.